So you're not really a web designer, and you're actually trying to DIY your own WordPress website. Lucky for you, in today's video, I'm gonna walk you through how to easily set up your WordPress website using Flywheel and Divi. There are tons of WordPress hosts out there, but I use Flywheel because they're so reliable and they have amazing customer service. And then when it comes to themes, there are millions of themes out there, but I use Divi because it's so customizable and it's so easy to keep your website up to date. So to start, you will need to create a Flywheel account. Once you've done that, you'll get an email to verify that you are the actual owner of the website. After you verify, you'll be able to set up. Now, click the Create a New Site button. You'll need to fill in a few basic details for your site, like the name, the temporary domain, and then the login information. You can choose to pay now or you can pay later. Once you've done all this, click the Launch Demo Site button and wait for Flywheel to work its magic. If you haven't paid yet, you'll get this white pop-up screen, which you can find the login details for on the Flywheel dashboard. Then you'll enter the actual WordPress login information you set up a few minutes ago. This white pop-up screen will no longer appear once you pay for your Flywheel account. Now you're in your WordPress dashboard and you're ready to get started. So as I mentioned earlier, I love the Divi theme, so you'll need to create an account, purchase a theme, and then download the zip file. You will upload the zip file into your WordPress account. You'll go to Appearance, Themes, and then click Add New at the top. Once it has fully uploaded onto your site, you'll click Activate. And now this is where the real fun starts. The first two things that I do when setting up a new Divi site is customize the default color palette for the client's brand. Then, neither of us have to remember every hex code when we're customizing the site. Next, I'll go to the theme customizer and set up all the other styling options within the theme, like fonts, colors, button styling, and all that. You can adjust these settings within each page and even sometimes within a particular module, but it will save you time if these styles are preset. Lastly, I'll make sure to install the Yoast SEO plugin and the Smush Image Compression and Optimization plugin. There are also lots of great Divi library packs and preloaded layouts that you can download or buy to save time on designing. Once you've done all this, you're ready to start loading content into your website. And the last thing that you'll need to do before you launch your website is actually connect your domain to your Flywheel account. I know you probably have some more WordPress questions, so let me know down in the comments below how I can help. But if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit like, subscribe, and share it with your friends.